The summer months bring thousands of people per week to Stanley. But in the winter, you know, it's a pretty different story. The National Weather Service calls it one of the coldest places in Idaho. KBOI2's Kelsey Anderson went to Stanley to see how they prepare before those temperatures drop.
The gateway to the Sawtooth Wilderness. This past summer, the Chamber of Commerce in Stanley believes about 2 million people traveled over Galena Summit toward the mountain town.
July is just bonkers. People are crawling over each other, but they're all having a wonderful time.
But summertime living only lasts so long here. And before folks know it, winter is looming.
Stanley in the teens this morning.
And this temperature is just the precursor to the real cold.
What does it feel like? Well, the dog sometimes looks at you, his whiskers are all white and he's frozen. He kind of looks at you like, oh, really, we're going for a walk now?
1931 building.
Tim Cron and his wife Becky are preparing for that freeze.
We have a few wood stoves, so there's a lot to get.
Like many in Stanley, they have piles and piles.
Maybe I'm a little obsessive about it, but.
of wood, ready for the cold temps ahead.
See, that's not sturdy.
Tim was busy winterizing his home when we caught up with him.
You don't really understand it until you're living here and your pipes freeze for the first time when you go, okay, I better figure this out or this is gonna be painful.
So how cold does it really get?
Well, let's see, January 1st this year, when I got up leisurely about 10 o'clock in the morning and looked at my thermometer, it was 26 below zero.
It can get to minus 40.
But don't worry, it doesn't really feel that cold.
A lot of the times, sunny and 35 below, you know, it feels like 10 below.
Well, maybe not that cold for those who live here.
I think your blood thickens when you've lived here for a while.
No, it's cold, but it's dry. And that makes a tremendous difference to how comfortable you are.
But the National Weather Service says the absolute coldest it's gotten in Stanley on December 23rd, 1983, the thermometer plummeted to a negative 54 degrees. Brr. And these picturesque mountains that bring so many here in the summer are the exact reason that thermometer drops. KBOI2's chief meteorologist Roland Stedham calls it a bowl effect. Cold air, which is very dense, looks for the lowest point it can find. Similar to Boise during our inversions, the cold air sinks into Stanley and gets stuck here. But in Stanley, the freezing temperatures are multiplied because the town sits at a higher elevation and it's a smaller bowl than ours here in the Treasure Valley. But even as chilly and quiet as this town gets,
as the weeks go on, I shut it down more and more. Until I'm down to 2 days a week in the winter.
Many of the 63 people who live here year-round will tell you this is the best time to be in Stanley.
I joke that you can go out and make snow angels on the highway.
The serenity of it all.
We see drama playing out among the wildlife.
The time to enjoy the peace and quiet.
We're so busy in the summertime that we really don't see our friends anymore. So come this time of year, the dinner parties start and getting together and doing things, you know, it's really a nice time. We look forward to it.
Just wear your coat and maybe an extra one too if you're headed out. I think I'll head out before those temperatures drop. In Stanley.
Sturdy.
Kelsey Anderson, KBOI 2 News.